G'day, Colin here. Thought I might go out and do some gardening. But I don't know, I was quite comfy on the lounge, so I might actually stay here and do some gardening. Gardening? Yes, you see, I'm going to make a little garden for inside. Have a look at this. I've got an egg box and I've popped some soil in it. Now, I've got these little things here. Very hard to see, but they're seeds. I'm going to plant some seeds. So I need to make a little hole, and that I'm going to do with this old pencil. So pop a little hole there, 2 and 3 and 4. And now, time to pop the seeds in. Okay, seeds. I'll try and put one in there. Couple in there, one in there, and one there. Right, seeds are in. Now I'll push them down. Down you go. Down you go. And in you go. Down you go. Now, a little bit of water. Need to water the seeds. Water the seeds. Have a drink. That's the way. Ah, there. Now, I'm going to make them grow. Grow, grow, grow. Nothing's happening. Why not? I think you know why, don't you? Because I don't make the seeds grow, do I? Who does? Yes, the Bible says God makes the seeds to grow, the plants to grow. So if I wait a long time, you know, it'll feel like a long time, then something special might happen. Little green shoot might pop up, and then after a while, it'll grow into a plant, and God will do that. But at the moment, look, nothing to see. It's all happening where I can't see it. And the Bible says that's what happens in the world. That's the way God works his plans sometimes. So have a listen to what God says in his word. In Isaiah chapter 46, verse 9 and 10, God says, I am God and there is no other. I am God and there is none like me. I say, my plan will stand and I will do all that I please. No matter what, God is still working. Sometimes it looks like nothing's happening. And other times it looks like everything is going wrong. But God has a plan and his plan will stand. Now, in Joshua chapter 1, verse 9, God says something special to his leader, Joshua. Joshua had some tough things to do, but listen to what God says to Joshua. Joshua chapter 1, verse 9. Haven't I commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Those are precious words to Joshua, aren't they? Precious words to us. And Jesus said something very similar to his disciples. Have a listen to this. This is in Jesus talking to his disciples in Matthew chapter 28, verse 20. Jesus said, and remember, I am with you always, to the end of the age. We can be strong and courageous, not because we're strong and courageous, we're not, but because Jesus is strong and Jesus is always with us. There's a song about that that I want to sing, and it's called Be Strong and Courageous. Be strong and courageous, the Lord of the ages holds all his little ones safe by his side. Be strong and courageous, the Lord of the ages holds all his little ones safe. Do not fear the fire, do not fear the fire, do not fear the waters, do not fear the waters, do not fear the thunder, do not fear the thunder. Jesus has conquered them all. Be strong and courageous, the Lord of the ages holds all his little ones safe by his side. Be strong and courageous, the Lord of the ages holds all his little ones safe. Do not fear the darkness, try it. Do not fear the darkness. Do not fear the sadness. Do not fear the sadness. Do not fear the sickness. Do not fear the sickness. Jesus has conquered them all. Be strong and courageous. The Lord of the ages holds all his little ones safe by his side. Strong and courageous. The Lord of the ages holds all his little ones safe. Do not fear the enemy, do not fear the enemy. Do not fear the poverty, do not fear the poverty. Do not fear eternity, do not fear eternity. Jesus has conquered them all. You try it. Be strong and courageous, the Lord of the ages holds all his little ones safe by his side. Be strong and courageous, the Lord of the ages holds all his little ones safe. He holds all his little ones safe. Well, that's a precious song that's been sung all over the world. I've sung it in churches, and I've heard people sing it in homes and hospitals. I once sang it in a church the day I met my compassion sponsor child, Chris. It was a special day, and I got to sing for him in a church in Cebu City in the Philippines. So it's a song that really does help us remember that God is strong and Jesus has conquered it all our troubles and all our trials. But it's also a song that helps us remember the poor and the weak and the sad. And why don't we pray for them now together? I think that'd be good. So I'm going to close my eyes to help me think about my prayers, and you might like to as well. Let's talk to God. Yeah. Our Almighty God, when we look around us in this world, there are times when we think nothing's happening, and other times we're scared at what we see is happening. But we thank you, like the seed beneath the ground, your plans are at work. Your plans will stand. You will do all that you please. And we thank you that you told Joshua, "Be strong and courageous, for I am with you." And we thank you that you say that to us as well in Jesus, that you are with us always to the end of the age. And we pray for those who are poor, that you will be close to them in their trials. We pray for those who are weak, that you will be their strength. And we pray for those who are sad, that you will be their joy. And Lord, if there's something you want us to do, please show us. But we thank you that you are strong. And we pray in our strong Savior's name. Amen. He holds all his little ones safe.